Hey, fellow scientists, Justin here. Our day did not go to plan. Mia and I went for a walk outside since the weather was so nice. It was sunny and it was perfect when we left. Not a cloud in the sky. Yeah, we didn't even think about grabbing an umbrella. But just a little while later, the sky turned dark, the wind picked up, and bam, we got caught in a rainstorm. What makes the weather change like that anyway? Let's get you dried off, Mia. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to identify what causes the weather and explain what causes it to change. Let's investigate. In our last lesson, we learned that weather is what's happening in the atmosphere at a certain time and place. It includes four big things: the temperature, how hot or cold the air is, the wind, how fast the air is moving, the clouds, which kinds and how many are in the sky, and the precipitation, any water falling to the ground, like rain or snow. What do you think makes all those things happen? Think back to the water cycle for a second. Before precipitation can happen, water has to evaporate or turn into water vapor. What warms up the water enough for it to evaporate? The sun. Heat from the sun is the energy source that powers not just the water cycle, but all the weather we see on Earth. The sun doesn't heat everything on Earth evenly. Kind of like when you try to heat up food in the microwave and it comes out cold in the middle. Some parts of the Earth get hotter, like places near the equator. Other parts stay cooler, like places near the North and South Poles. Even different surfaces heat up unevenly. Land warms up faster than water and cools down faster too. Because the Earth heats unevenly, the air above it also heats unevenly. Some areas of air are warm and others are cool. This difference is what causes all the things that make up the weather: temperature, wind, clouds, and precipitation. How do you think uneven heating affects the temperature we feel outside? Well, if there's more warm air in an area, the temperature is higher. And if there's more cool air, the temperature is lower. And warm and cold air have more differences than just temperature. When air is cold, it's actually heavier, so it sinks down toward the ground. Warm air is lighter, so it floats up higher in the atmosphere. When warm air rises and cool air sinks, it gets the air moving. That movement of air is what we call wind. Sometimes the air moves slowly and we feel a soft breeze. Other times it moves quickly and we get strong winds that can shake the trees. The bigger the difference in temperature, the faster the air moves. And all that air isn't moving around on its own. Do you remember what else is floating in the atmosphere, even if we can't see it? Water vapor. The amount of water vapor in the air is called humidity. Sometimes there's only a little water vapor and the air feels dry. Other times the air is full of water vapor, or humid, which makes the air feel sticky or heavy, like a wet blanket. Ick. Have you ever experienced a humid day? When the air felt sticky and heavy like that, what was the temperature like? It's usually when it's hot out that you start to notice humidity. That's because warm air can hold more water vapor than cold air can. And what does warm air do? It rises. As humid air rises into the atmosphere and cools down, the water vapor condenses and forms clouds. The more humid the air is, the more water vapor there is to form clouds. When the air in the atmosphere is less humid, fewer clouds can form and the sky stays clearer. And we know that as more and more water droplets gather inside a cloud, the cloud gets heavier. When the droplets become too heavy to stay floating in the air, they fall back down to Earth as precipitation. So, the uneven heating of the Earth is the root cause of each of the different weather conditions we observe: temperature, wind, clouds, and precipitation. But we can also observe the weather conditions changing all the time, like when Mia and I got caught in that rainstorm. So what causes the weather to change? The weather changes all the time because large bodies of air, called air masses, are constantly moving across the Earth. An air mass is a large section of the atmosphere that has the same temperature and humidity throughout. Some air masses are warm and some are cold, depending on where they formed, over warm oceans, cold lands, or other areas. Wind moves air masses from place to place. What do you think happens when two different air masses meet? They don't mix together easily. Instead, they push against each other, and the place where they meet is called a front. Fronts are where a lot of weather changes happen. There are two common types of fronts, warm fronts and cold fronts. At a warm front, a warm air mass moves into an area with cooler air. Because warm air is lighter, it rises slowly over the cooler air. This rising air forms clouds and often brings steady rain or drizzle. Because it moves slowly, this weather can last for a long time. But after a warm front passes, the weather usually feels warmer and the skies often clear up. At a cold front, a cold air mass moves into an area with warmer air. Since cold air is heavier, it pushes the warm air up much more quickly. This can cause thicker clouds, heavy rain, thunderstorms, or even snow. After a cold front passes, the weather usually feels cooler and the skies can clear up quickly. So there must have been a front on my walk with Mia this morning. Since the weather changed so quickly into a heavy rainstorm, do you think it was a warm front or a cold front? Yeah, it was probably a cold front. Cold fronts can bring fast changes in the weather, like sudden rainstorms. That's why it went from sunny to stormy so quickly. If it had been a warm front, we might have had a little more warning before the weather turned. When air masses meet and form fronts, they can cause big changes in the weather. Sometimes, all in just a few minutes. Let's review everything we've learned today. The sun's uneven heating of the Earth causes the weather. Uneven heating creates differences in temperature, wind, clouds, and precipitation. Moving air masses and fronts bring new weather conditions like rain, storms, and changes in temperature. To learn more about the causes of weather, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Well, now we know, Mia, the uneven heating of the Earth is the reason we have weather, and the reason I have some very soggy socks. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time. Hey, hey.